Morning everyone. Today we learn about a poem, Childhood. Very first thing children, it's not poem, it's poem. The exact pronunciation of the word P-O-E-M is poem. Okay? So today we learn about a poem, Childhood. It is there in your hornbill. Okay. Let's begin. Sorry. So it's written by Marcus Nathan. He's the author of the poem. Marcus Nathan is a poet from Norway. Details of his life are very sketchy. Sketchy as in not known much. No details are there about his life. It's just known that he's from Norway and nothing is clear. So it's unclear when and where was he born. Okay. Children, before getting into the poem, I would like to summarize it. Childhood. Children, childhood is a very emotional word. When we hear about it, we remember so many happy moments that we have lived when we were children. When we were small, when we were young. When we were young, we used to think we should grow up quickly, we'll enjoy life. But once we grow up, we realize that childhood was much better. Yeah? So same way, it happens with each and every one of us, majority of us, that we feel that childhood was the golden era, the golden time of our lives. Okay, so same way the poet is discussing the loss of his childhood. The poet talks about that very moment where this innocence was lost. Children is equals to innocence. They're so innocent, they don't know whom to talk what, they don't discriminate between poor, rich, they treat everyone equal, they love everybody the same way, they don't know about the society, they're so pure-hearted, just like God, close to God. Okay, so same way the poet talks about the various examples, the various instances when he could have lost his childhood. The author feels that his childhood went to some forgotten place. So in this very poem, the poet is remembering his childhood, how he lived it or how he lost it. Okay, let's get into it. When did my childhood go? Was it the day I ceased to be 11? The boy is questioning, he's asking himself, then when did my childhood go? Was it when I was 11? Ceased to be when I became? Was it the time I realized that hell and heaven could not be found in geography and therefore could not be? Was that the day? Children, geography is a subject in which we come to know about the world, the details, the longitudes, the latitudes, the maps, the location, the areas, okay, the kilometers, the square kilometers, okay, geography is all about that. So he's saying that when I came to know that apart from geography, there's a whole world, there's a world of heaven, there's a world of hell. Hell as in when we do bad deeds, we go to hell. Heaven as in a good place, when we do good deeds, we go there. Okay, so this is a philosophy of life. So he's saying that when I realized about the philosophy of life, when I realized what life is about, what life is all about, was that time when I grew up? When did my childhood go? Was it the time I realized that adults were not all they seemed to be? Adults were not means something is thinking something else, speaking something else, the double-faced people, the double-standard people, they're talking very politely with you, but inside they have grudges from you, yeah? They talk ill about you. The same way he's saying that because children don't realize all these things, kids are not able to manipulate things or they are not able to judge people. But we as adults, when we grow up, we do realize who's coming with a good intention, who's coming with positive vibes, who's coming with a happy feeling or a bad feeling, the good vibes. We can feel that. Why? Because we've seen life. We have been through many, many circumstances, maybe good or bad, each one of us. Yes? They talked of love and preached of love, but did not act so lovingly. Was that the day? He's saying that they always spoke about the lovey-dovey things, the love they possess for each other, but inside, in their hearts, they didn't really do that. Was that the day when he realized people are talking to each other in a very lovingly manner, in a very happy way? He's saying, was that the day when I realized that talking something and meaning something are two different things? When did my childhood go? Was it when I found my mind was really mine? To use whichever way I choose? Okay, children, we all have heard from our elders, from our grandparents, that always there are two ways or two lanes to possess anything. One is the good one, one is the bad one. It is our choice in which road, in which area, where do we have to move. We all have studied road not taken. Same way, the tough road, the good one, makes us uncomfortable, but at the end that is very, very good for us in the long run. Producing thoughts that were not those of other people but my own and mine alone. Was that the day? Children, we all are individual. We all think differently. We all have many, many point of views. Yeah? So same way the author is saying that it was it the day when I thought, when I had started thinking about life my own way, like my own thoughts presumed me. Children, we all behave from our surroundings, how our surroundings are, how our parents are, the teachings we hold, each and every day or every situation, the reaction we give, it is the same way, the surroundings, okay? Where did my childhood go? It went to some forgotten place that it hidden in an infant's face. That's all I know. Infant as in baby. He's saying, I don't know that when did I forget my childhood, when did I lose my innocence. I don't know when I saw life, when I saw the changing faces of people, that time did I change, when I myself changed some thoughts, started thinking about hell and heaven. Infants, why is it is compared to infants' face, kids? Because when you see a baby face, a newborn baby, it is the most purest form of love of human being. It is so pure, automatically we get attached to the child, even if we know them or we don't know. The child is so pure, so positivity is there in that child that we automatically get attached. Why? Because there are no ill feelings, no bad vibes, only happiness and positivity. We feel we are next to God. Why? Because child is a pure soul. Okay? It was a very good and deep poem, children. Let's read further so that we understand it better. This is the introduction. In the poem Childhood, the poet ponders deeply over the question of his lost childhood. Ponders means he's always running. He's running to the point that where is my childhood? Why did I lose it? He recalls a number of stages when his thought and perceptions about the world and people changed. Perceptions as in the thinking of people changed. He tries to identify that one particular stage or time when he lost his childhood and stepped into adulthood. Adulthood means knowing about the world, knowing about the phenomena of nature, the changing situations, the changing behavior of the people. He feels a sense of nostalgia. What do you mean by nostalgia? Nostalgia is remembering something of your past, so deeply remembering it. For the lost childhood, and finally settles down with an idea that his childhood has gone to some forgotten place and that place would could be found in an infant's innocent face.